Good morning, everyone, and so good to see everybody, and it's great to have you with us today. We have a wonderful service for you today, and I'd just like to introduce myself. I'm Reverend Tanya Dawson, Associate Minister here with Ministry Coordinator Helen Wright, and I'd like to bring you this morning's spiritual reading right off the bat. And first I'd like to say it is given to us by Reverend Alden Studebaker, Helen's mentor, actually, not the one that was assigned by Unity of Worldwide Ministries, but the one that came through Spirit, naturally, as you might say. I guess it all comes through Spirit, but they've been working together for some time and playing together and so on. And he's also very good friends with the Brilliants. I just want to tell you a little story very quickly. It was through Kay and Virginia, knowing Reverend Alden, that we were able to find Helen when Kay had reached out to Alden, Reverend Alden, and told us, yes, well, as a matter of fact, I do know of someone who happens to be in Albuquerque right now, and she was up there on vacation. And that's how we got Minister Coordinator Helen, our Helen. So that's the story. And I just want to read this briefly, and you'll be hearing from Reverend Alden later in the service, and you'll get a full-on introduction by Helen. Forgiveness isn't so much forgiving a wrong that's been done. Rather, it's about freeing ourselves to fully express the spiritual being that lies just below the surface of our momentary unforgiveness. So let's make forgiveness a regular, ongoing spiritual practice. Like when Jesus was asked by Peter, how often should one forgive? He said, I do not say to you up to seven times, but up to 70 times seven, meaning there is no end to forgiveness. Thank you, Reverend Alden. God is good. God is good all the time, and all are welcome, safe, and loved. Today's speaker, as you know, is Reverend Alden, and we have also, our music today is also brought by Reverend Alden. So this is a beautiful, exciting service to have. And he is actually in Missouri going to be doing these things. And now for some good news. Ken Warner, our YouTube and Zoom producer, and also the president of the board, has some good news for us today.
Thank you, Tanya. So this is one little item I found on the Good News Network. As you can see, the link up on top if you want to go get a little more information. But it's really kind of neat with all the masks wearing and everything that we're required to do with our day-to-day function now is a couple of ladies got together and put an Etsy shop together where you can go out and order something, send them a picture of your favorite pet, a dog, a cat, or whatever, and they will put that information screen printed onto a mask and allow you to be able to match your dog just like the pictures you know here if you're choosing to do so. It's just kind of cute that people are trying to bring the animal part of their lives out and share it with other people in the world with all the restrictions that we have right now. I just thought it was kind of cute. But it is something to go out and look at. There's a link up there if you want to take a look at it. You can go out and do it manually. But otherwise, just go to goodnewsnetwork.org and you can probably find it. That's the way I found it. Hope you guys have a great time and hope you've enjoyed this. Tanya, back to you.
Thank you, Ken. If you have some good news that you've seen during the week, please send it to Ken, attention to Ken at unitylascruces@gmail.com. Again, that's unitylascruces@gmail.com. And we'd like to share the news that you find good and uplifting. And just give him a little time to be able to put it together for the service, perhaps maybe Friday or Saturday, and send it on. And I'd like to ask you to join me for a moment of gratitude. We, all of us at Unity of Las Cruces, are so grateful for everyone who enlivens this church, including those behind the scenes, you who attend, and those here in the Zoom, and also those who are watching it later on YouTube or watching it again on YouTube. And our channel on YouTube is Unity Las Cruces. And we'd like to thank all the other folks. We have so many, and I'm not going to go through each and every single one, but you know, we have prayer chaplaincy, we have prayer teams, we have, which are all associated, we have social media, we're on Facebook, we're on Instagram, our board, of course, they do so much wonderful work, and all of the anonymous prayers, the musicians, and the speakers, the the thing is that we all do make a difference. We all really do make a difference as we raise the vibration of this earth through our prayers, our affirmations, and our visualizations. And we want to thank you for that. Thank you so much. And now please join us with Ministry Coordinator Helen Wright with the opening prayer. Thank you.
Thank you, Tanya. Let's just take a moment to go within. Maybe taking a nice, deep, cleansing breath and breathing out any tensions, any conversations, any actions before we came together this morning. So Father, Mother, God, Spirit of the living, loving God, in us, through us, and as us. We are grateful, most grateful, again, to be able to come together in spiritual community, connecting with our hearts and our minds, connecting through the inspiration and the words that we'll be hearing from Reverend Alden. Connecting with this time together, where we truly can be together and can feel uplifted and supported by every one of us. So in this time of prayer, we open to peace, we open to inspiration, we open to forgiveness, we open to receptivity. And for all of this, we are so grateful and we say, thank you, thank you, thank you, God. And so it is. So now I would like to introduce John Powers, bringer of the good word in the form of the daily word. So welcome, John.
Thank you. I imagine a world transformed by peace and love. This is the daily word for September 6, 2020. World peace begins within my mind and heart. Closing my eyes, I breathe deeply and envision every person bringing forth the love and peace of God. I see all of the world's people surrounded by a healing light that transforms strife, anger, and division into reconciliation, peace, and unity. As I hold this vision, I see the entire world aglow with radiance, harmony, and cooperation, heal the world's wounds, and encourage love to flower in each person's heart. I carry this vision throughout my day. Divine love, expressing as me, sees oneness regardless of apparent differences. Divine wisdom and understanding illumine my thoughts, inspire my words, and guide me to act in ways that bring peace to the world. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Matthew 5, verse 9.
Thank you, John. I believe next we go into our affirmation for unity.
Join me as we affirm our prayer for unity of Las Cruces. Guided by infinite love and wisdom, and with God as our source, we now behold unlimited possibilities as unity of Las Cruces grows and prospers. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Kay. And now it gives me great pleasure to be able to introduce our speaker, Reverend Alden Studebaker. He was born in the Northwest Indiana and raised from age 10 in Honolulu, Hawaii. At age 15, Alden became a member of the Youth of Unity at the Church of Hawaii and served as its president. In 1980, Alden received a BA degree with a major in religion from Western Michigan University in Kalamazoo, Michigan. In 1982, he entered the Unitarian Ministerial School. And while in school, he served as the student minister of an outreach ministry in Leavenworth, Kansas, as the chaplain at a nearby military prison. After his graduation and ordination in 1984, Reverend Alden served as a Unity Ministries from California to Wisconsin, specifically Bakerville, California, El Paso, Texas, La Crescenta, California, Bellevue, Washington, and then was at Garden Park Unity in Cincinnati for 10 years. He most recently served at Unity of Eau Claire, Unity Christ Center in Eau Claire, Wisconsin. He's also served on many ministry teams for the regions and for Unity Worldwide Ministries over the years. While on sabbatical between church assignments, Reverend Alden wrote a manuscript for a Bible handbook specifically geared for the metaphysically minded student. In 1998, Wisdom for a Lifetime, How to Get the Bible Off the Shelf and Into Your Hands, was published by Unity Books. Since its publication, Alden has traveled around the country presenting talks and workshops on the benefits of positive, practical Bible study and has been interviewed many times. To date, the book has sold over 13,000 copies. And following the success of Wisdom for a Lifetime, Alden wrote three more books, The Grid and The Fault, both novels, and I highly recommend them. And the more comedic book, Hosieritis. He's also the editor and publisher of his brother's autobiography, Not Just Any Bag of Bones. And he recently completed the second edition of the Bible Handbook entitled Wisdom for a Lifetime in the 21st Century. And I met Reverend Alden in Wisconsin, and we immediately bonded over things like his love of trees, his love of cats, and his incredible generous spirit as he connects with people and shares his wisdom. So please help me welcome Reverend Alden.
Well, thank you, Helen. Yeah, it was great meeting you back. Gosh, it's been more than a couple of years ago when I first interviewed in Eau Claire, Wisconsin. Helen was on the search team as well as a alternate on the board of trustees, and we just immediately hit it off and began working together. She in the ministerial training process, so we helped to my wife and I both helped to support her with that, and we did a lot of I think very good work there. In Eau Claire until we moved on. But I really appreciate her invitation and your invitation to welcome me back to Unity of Las Cruces. And when I say that, I actually have spoken in your church back when I was a road warrior out there sharing a bit about the Bible handbook. I did a seminar in El Paso, Unity of El Paso, and also a talk at Unity of Las Cruces, and that was back on October 8th, 2006. So time has flown, 14 years, and so good to come to you in Las Cruces in a virtual way. Well, today we're going to talk about cactus, something I discovered when I first moved to the Southwest, when I moved to El Paso back in quite a while ago. Became very familiar with the flora of the desert Southwest. It's not the kind of plant you think of growing back east. I mean, you drive around here in western Missouri, it's not something you see just driving along the road. You don't really see them anywhere. But if we can just put up the next slide, I want to share with you some cacti. They're called cacti when there's more than one. I like the word cactuses better, but maybe we'll just use cactuses for the rest of this time this morning. These prickly pear cacti, that shot comes from the top of the Clubhouse Hill in Dune Acres, Indiana, overlooking Lake Michigan. Yep, as a kid, I grew up in Dune Acres, and I remember seeing this prickly pear cactus as a kid walking the dunes there. Well, there's all kinds of cactuses or cacti. When most people think about cactus, they think of the giant saguaro cactus in Arizona, a very statuesque tree, not recommended by the Tree Hugging Society of America, I must say, unless you want quite a hug from that tree. But there are all kinds of them all over the world. And, you know, there are all kinds of spiny plants. If we could go to the next slide, I want to share another shot of, I think, the saguaro's cousin. This is the giant sorrel's cousin in southern Indiana, otherwise known as the honey locust tree. Those spines on that tree can get to be over a foot long, and I understand the native people use those spines to make needles that they used in doing their sewing. Definitely not on the tree-hugging list of trees. But there are thousands of varieties of them, and they grow, again, almost in every state. I don't know if they grow in Alaska or not, but I think they pretty much grow almost everywhere in the 48 states. There are some in a state I grew up in Hawaii. For the next slide, we're going to show you the worst of the cactuses of the world. Oh, yes. Look familiar? The teddy bear choya. Teddy bear choya. You won't find these back east. Now, if you've been anywhere near this particular cacti or cactus, you know you don't want to get anywhere near it. Those spines are razor sharp. And when the pieces of this cactus get on the ground, it's almost as if they want to leap up on you, don't they? And God help you if you get stuck by them, as we see in the next slide. Oh, yeah. Ouch. You definitely don't want to get near them. On this one, he ran into one of those teddy bears that decided to jump on him and climb on top of him. This was the tamest slide I could find of people interacting with teddy bear choya. You don't want to touch them. And when you walk by one of those plants, you want to keep at least 6 inches away because it's almost as if they'll jump on top of you. Now, I'm not here today to talk to you about the horticulture of the desert Southwest. Those of you who live in Las Cruces, you already know pretty much about it. But it's about what these plants represent in our spiritual process. We unknowingly can be like the guy in that photo who let the cacti attack us. And sometimes we do it without even thinking. There's a popular term called sitting on the cactus. If you look in the Urban Dictionary, it's defined as when you do something so undesirable, it's akin to sitting bare derriere for, I'm not going to tell you exactly what it's defined as, but you get the idea of sitting on a spiky plant like a cactus. Such as, I sat on the cactus last night trying to catch up on a book, or I was sitting on the cactus for 3 hours trying to finish that movie. Well, our lives are full of prickly experiences, undesirable experiences. Now, not every day, thankfully, but every now and then we run into one of these things. Like when we're out driving and somebody cuts you off. Well, we haven't been doing as much driving so much the last few months, so maybe we haven't had that many experiences of other people out there doing things with their cars that we find prickly or unpleasant. Although the other day when my wife and I were heading up to this small town near us called Lexington, we go up there about every couple of weeks to mow my brother-in-law's property that he has up there. And we had come up to a stop, actually to an intersection, and the guy in front of me was making a right turn. And as I started to go through the intersection after his turn, the guy who was sitting on the right side decided to pull his pickup truck out right in front of me. And I have to admit, I sat on a cactus for a little while, did some deep breathing and thought, well, I guess he needed to make that turn right then. But our lives are full of all these things. You go to your local grocery store and you're pushing your cart to your car and somebody decides that the parking lot there is a place for checking out the high speed of their vehicle. And we probably think to ourselves, well, where's the fire here? What you in such a hurry for? And that's a natural reaction. But if we let it bug us all day, we're doing what? We're sitting on the cactus. And that is unpleasant. And it's something we don't really need to do. Now, the writer of the Four Agreements, Don Miguel Ruiz, this is a classic spiritual book, One of the four agreements or precepts that he shares, it just really stands out, and I think is one that just speaks to me all the time, is don't take anything personally. Don't take anything personally. Nothing that others do is because of us. And why is that? It's because we aren't maybe that important to whoever that person is who's doing something that's bothering us. What other people do or say is more a projection of what's in their minds, what's going on inside of them, and what Don Miguel Ruiz calls their dream. Well, when you're immune to the opinions of other people, the actions of others, it's then that we can avoid sitting on the cactus. We don't become the victim of others' actions. We don't become the victim of needless suffering. Needless suffering. And so taking life's experiences personally is sitting on a cactus, holding a grudge, reliving a negative experience over and over and over again. It's like driving the spines of that teddy bear Choya right into not so much our derriere, but into our psyche, into our soul, into our consciousness. And for what? Why are we doing it? Do we really like pain that much? Joyce Meyer wrote, "Being negative only makes the journey difficult. You may be given a cactus, but you don't have to sit on it." So sitting on a cactus is always an optional experience. No one ever said, you have to do it. You have to get down on that cactus now that just happened to you. No, you don't have to. You really don't. And there are all kinds of cactuses in the world, people who do harmful things, thoughtless things. And it's not easy. Sometimes it's hard to avoid the cactus seat because our emotions get triggered by stuff. And I think maybe even more so, not so much when it's happening to us, but when it's happening to other people. It's not so much about what happens to us, but about what happens to others. And so our response to life's challenges is always our choice. Can we turn on the next slide, please? There we go. There's one of those saguaro cactuses out there in the Arizona desert. And up on top there is a kitty. Way up there. You see it? You know, sometimes we're like that cat. We'll just crawl up on top of that cactus, spine sticking in our chest, because we don't want to let go of something that happened. Yeah, we're up there in pain and we're cringing. And there's a part of us that thinks, you know, I just can't let go of this. This is just not a forgivable kind of thing. We read in the book of Matthew these words of Jesus. He says, if you forgive the others' wrongs they have done to you, your Father in heaven will also forgive you. But if you don't forgive others, then your Father will not forgive the wrongs you have done. Forgiveness is at the core of Jesus' teachings. When I think of all the different spiritual leaders, founders of religions of the world, I think forgiveness is something that really distinguishes Jesus from all of them. Well, if we want our consciousness to be clear of pain, of needless suffering, we've got to let go. We've got to forgive. And it's not so much that we're forgiving others because, well, we need to forgive them so much, as it is about what takes place inside of us in a spiritual way. So we have to look at ourselves and decide, are we willing to do it? Are we willing to become spiritually free inwardly? Next slide, please. Because sometimes we get stuck in this state of mind. Oh yeah. No forgiveness. Because maybe we feel that others don't really deserve it. They don't really deserve it. But let's remember, it's not about forgiving other people. It's about you and me and all of us. Because people that have done things that are thoughtless, where they aren't really being compassionate, or they're not really thinking about what they're doing, and we forgive them, chances are maybe they don't really care what we think at that point. So it's not so much about them. It's about our spiritual welfare, of carrying around that Choya cactus stuck in our craw, stuck in our hearts, stuck in our minds, stuck in our emotions. Because when that happens, we are not able to express our true spiritual selves. We are blocked. We are inhibited from being our true selves. The thing is this about the world. Our world would not progress. Our world would not improve if it were not for people choosing to forgive the wrongs that have happened over the centuries. And we can see that playing out today and what's taking place in our world. Many, many things that we witness through our media, and we think to ourselves, oh my goodness, what are these folks doing? The best thing we can do is to learn to let go of how we feel about it, to send forth a sense of blessings. Because if we don't, we will feel stuck. We'll be feeling stuck as if all of the teddy bear Choya in the world were wrapped around our bodies. We don't want to experience that. Nobody does. So it's forgiveness that allows that cacti to be painlessly removed from our souls, from our feeling nature, from our consciousness. And this applies to big things and to little things. We can easily find ourselves sitting on a cactus over something that is so small and so insignificant to the whole unfoldment of life. Next slide. That's my trailer. It's a utility trailer. And when I moved that up to Wisconsin, of course, I painted it Packer green and yellow. It's still that color, even down here in Missouri. And so when I moved to Wisconsin from Indiana, you'll see the Indiana license plates on it. I was under the assumption that I had to get the trailer licensed. And so I went to the Department of Motor Vehicles and I walked in there with those photos of the trailer on my phone to the DMV office, walked up to the guy, held up my phone, you know, like this. And I said, I have this trailer that I need to license. What do I do? It is a small trailer, as you can see. And he said, sure. That'll be $120. And I'm thinking, gosh, that's a lot of money to just license a little trailer. And I thought, boy, Wisconsin, they got some really serious motor vehicle fees here, don't they? So I went along with it, and I bought the Wisconsin trailer license plate. And one day I was over at the Unity Church where I served for a work party. And one of the men who's in charge of our outdoor grounds team, his name is Dale, was looking at my trailer and he said, Alden, do you know that in Wisconsin you don't need to have a plate on your trailer? I said, really? I said, that's not what they said at the DMV. He says, no, you really don't need them. Those trailer plates are for large trailers, big trailers. I said, really? Oh my goodness, I didn't know that. And a part of me thought, how come that guy at the DMV didn't say that to me? So I wrote to the DMV and said, hey, you guys didn't tell me I didn't need this plea. How about a refund? Well, I got a response from Emily CM112. And Emily said, dear Alden, thank you for writing the Wisconsin Department of Transportation website. Per Wisconsin statute, registration is optional for trailers or camping trailers weighing 3,000 pounds or less when loaded. The statute states that these vehicles are exempt from registration. However, it is recommended that a plate be applied for a trailer if it is to be operated in another state. Unfortunately, Wisconsin law does not allow for a refund after the registration period has begun. When you receive a license plate renewal notice for the plates you're no longer using, you may ignore the renewal license. If you do not renew this year, you will not get another renewal notice from us. I looked at that and I thought, I don't know. So I wrote Emily back. I said, dear Emily, when I went to the DMV back in October to register the trailer, the clerk did not inform me that it was unnecessary. I even showed him the photos of the trailer on my phone that I have included in this email. And clearly this is a small utility trailer that does not require registration or plates according to Wisconsin law. Why did he not inform me? I have no intention of taking it out of state. Why won't you give me a refund? I'm not pleased with the clerk's lack of transparency about the Wisconsin motor vehicle laws with me, the public. He offered no explanation. If you won't give me a refund, please refer me to someone who can, a supervisor. Your agency made the mistake and you need to rectify it or refund me. Thank you, Alden Studebaker. I got an email back from Emily's supervisor, Mercedes. Alden, thank you for using the Wisconsin Department of Transportation's website. I apologize if you feel the Wisconsin DMV was not more transparent concerning this matter. I can assure you we always want to provide all possible options to customers regarding optional registration for trailers with a gross weight of 3,000 pounds or less. The information is not only available on our website, on several different pages, which I will link below. It is listed on the Wisconsin title and license plate application that you filled out to transfer the title and obtain plates in section F pictured below. It is the vehicle owner's responsibility to review the registration options available and select the one that best applies to their use of the vehicle. We're always more than happy to discuss registration options in greater depth when asked. Unfortunately, as Emily stated, once the registration period started, we aren't able to provide refunds. Thank you for taking the time to provide us with your valuable feedback. Your comments are much appreciated and will be forwarded to our management team. I must confess, I sat on a cactus for quite a while. And then I realized, you know, Alden, you're sitting on a cactus. And I thought to myself, that $121.38, you're welcome to it, Wisconsin Department of Motor Vehicles. You know, sometimes you have to pay to learn the lessons of life. In fact, I think that when we do have to pay, we remember them better. And we remember that when we run into similar situations that can cause a feeling of anger, of upset, a feeling like we're having something pulled over on us, that we're able to go, you know, in the whole scheme of life, is it really, really that important? Does it really, really feel good to have a teddy bear choya stuck in your room anywhere? Now, forgiveness doesn't mean that we accept what others do so much. It just means that what others do doesn't control us anymore. So how can we take control of our experience of these cacti of life? Charles Fillmore suggested this practice. And he said, here is a mental treatment that is guaranteed to cure every ill that flesh is heir to. Sit for a half hour every night and mentally forgive everyone against whom you have any ill will or antipathy. If you fear or if you are prejudiced against even an animal, mentally ask forgiveness of it and send it thoughts of love. If you have accused anyone of injustice, if you have discussed anyone unkindly, if you've criticized or gossiped about anyone, withdraw your words by asking them in the silence to forgive you. If you had a falling out with friends or relatives, if you're at law or engaged in contention with anyone, do everything in your power to end the separation. See all things and all persons as they really are, pure spirit, and send them your strongest thoughts of love. Do not go to bed any night feeling that you have an enemy in the world. Next slide. We can change. We can go from unforgiveness to I forgive. And you can see, this is the same cat. He made that switch. Forgiveness is probably the most important daily practice that we can engage in, because it clears our consciousness. It clears our subconscious of all of those blocks that can get in the way of the flow of spirit. Next slide. And so when we learn to forgive, we learn not to sit on the cactus seat. And now let us take some time to go into a moment of meditation. And I invite you to take a moment to breathe. When you're ready, close your eyes and just feel your whole body relaxing. Letting go of any outer distractions, letting your feet rest comfortably on the floor, your hands in your lap in a relaxed way, and close your eyes. And we take these next few minutes to let go of all of the demands, all of the requirements of the outer world. For we are here now in this moment to feel and experience the fullness of joy and of love and of truth that flow forth from spirit. Spirit that is within us, all around us, wherever we go in life. And to help us do that, let's become aware of the flow of our breathing. Breathe in deeply. And then let go of that breath. And again, breathe in again. And feel that your entire being is filled with light, filled with divine energy and power. And as we breathe out, we let go of all of the concerns, worries, and fears that we may have been aware of previously. And in this now moment, we embrace the peace, power, and love that is always there within us. And we open our hearts to that flow of forgiving love. There is within each one of us this power to clear away anything that no longer serves us, to deny that it has any power over our lives. And if anything comes to mind now that has been disturbing you, bothering you. Look at it as if you're looking at an object. And then feel from your heart this blessing of love and forgiveness that now releases any energy we might have tied up in that experience, in that feeling of unhappiness or unforgiveness. If it involves a person, let their image come to your mind. Just feel the power of love flowing through you that releases any animosity or feelings of unhappiness toward that person. It is in this way that we are transformed, that we open up to a power greater than our physical selves or our emotional or intellectual selves. We open up to our real selves. We open up to that spark of divinity, that child of God that is us and always has been and always will be. And so for the next few moments, sit in the calm and quiet of this space and feel your connection with spirit, with love, with forgiveness in the silence. And now let us gently come back from this time of meditation. And as we do, we give thanks for the experience of our connection with spirit. And we are grateful for the energy, the light, and the love that we now experience and will carry forward into the rest of this day. And we give thanks for this time of inner reflection and meditation, and do so in the name and through the power of the living Christ presence within us all. And so it is. Amen.
Hello, everybody. Alden Studebaker here. I was asked to consider doing a song for this Sunday, and I thought about it and about what so many of us are going through these days, all the restrictions that are involved with COVID and having to social distance. We may be feeling a little bit more lonely than we normally would. And so I'd like to share a song with you now called Lonely People. You might recognize it from the 70s, and it's a song I've always enjoyed and hope you will too. Here goes.
Thank you, Reverend Alden. That was beautiful, beautiful music and a very powerful message about not sitting on those spikes. So we really appreciate it. Thank you. And now we have our prayer for faith with Kay Brilliant.
Welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. Please join me in prayer as we affirm our prayer of faith. God is my help in every need. God does my every hunger feed. God dwells within me, guides my way through every moment, night and day. I now am wise, I now am true. Patient, kind, and loving too. All things I am, can do, and be. Through Christ, the truth is in me. God is my health, I can't be sick. God is my strength, unfailing quick. God is my all, I know no fear, since God and love and truth are here. Amen.
Our tithe for this week is going to Daily Word with Unity Worldwide Ministries. They're one of their publications that we love.
Welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. Your love blessings can be made at the Unity of Las Cruces website or on the weekly email. You can mail your gift, donation, or tithe to the P.O. Box. Your gift is given in love, goes out to the others in love, and love returns tenfold. And so it is.
So speaking next week, I will be speaking next week, and the title is Good Grief, Tears in the Soup. So looking at the grieving process. And then our next slide is the September speakers. So moving forward, after the next week, we have a joint service with the Center for Spiritual Living on peace and peace in our world through prayer. And then on September 27th, there is Reverend Tanya Dawson will be speaking. So we look forward to that too. Thank you. We continue the WWW, the Welcome the Word on Wednesdays. So Wednesday mornings at 9:30, a small group of us gather and we read the daily word and then share insights about the daily word and then have some time in prayer. So please join us. The link is always in our weekly email. Reverend Bonnie is holding a class on building our healing consciousness, and the update is this class will be starting on the 17th of September. Please call CSL if you want to be included in the class, and I believe all of the in-person socially distanced spaces are now taken, so we could attend by Zoom if we want to do that. I'm going to say call CSL. And as you heard earlier, Reverend Alden has now published his revised version of Wisdom for a Lifetime, but now in the 21st century. I certainly have the original book. It's an excellent book and written in a really readable format. It's user-friendly, should I say. So recommending that book, and Reverend Alden, maybe if you could stay after the service and answer questions if there are any. So thank you. So again, really appreciating and thanking Reverend Alden for his inspiring message today and his beautiful music. We are truly grateful. Please reach out to each other this week. We continue to be socially distanced and mostly at home, but we don't have to be alone. So reach out and connect. Thank you all so much for attending this virtual Sunday celebration. And we look forward to seeing you next week. And you're certainly welcome to stay after the service for conversation and questions and connection and catch up. So now we're going to do unmuted everyone for the prayer of protection, even though it sounds a little bit sort of overlapping and everything. And then we'll go into a muted, let there be peace on earth. Thank you.
Please join us as we affirm the prayer for protection. The light of God
surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us.
Where we are,
wherever
God is.
Woohoo!
That's so true.
Oh my God, that was funny.
Uh huh.
There be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as Creator, family all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me, let this be the moment with every step I take, let this be my solemn vow, to take each moment and live each moment in peace eternal.
Ha ha ha.
again. Thank you, everyone, and let peace be with us during our following this coming week. Thank you so much. Namaste.
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 There we are.
There we are. There's everybody.
Yeah.
Thank you, Alden.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Awesome.